好啦，咁啊，首先我歡迎大家嚟到呢個 CFA Level 1嘅seminar 啦 ，information seminar。咁啊，亦都好多謝啦嚇。咁啊，有可能有其他朋友咧，就係 online join 緊我哋嘅嚇。咁啊，今年都係教育界嘅特色嘅啦嚇。咁好多啲 classes 咧都係 live and online 嚇。咁而家今次亦都係呢個 info sessions 咧嚇。咁啊 ，live and online 嚇。咁希望咧，真係上堂嗰陣時咧，就冇啲咁嘅 restrictions 啦嚇。咁啊，大家可以即係又唔使戴口罩啊，咁啊方便好多。好啦，咁啊少少我自己嘅 background 啦嚇。咁啊 ，Larry Yuen， 咁啊我就係 Kaplan 嘅 full time lecturer 啦。咁啊負責 CFA 啦，同埋 CAIA 嘅classes 嘅。咁啊之前咧，直都喺銀行嗰度咧就做咗若干年嘅時間啦，咁啊包括喺 asset management 同埋 private banking 啦，嚇，咁啊都好 appropriate 嘅，啲工作經驗喺呢個 course 入邊。先，咁啊今日主要係嗰個 agenda 咧，可以分到三個部分啦。咁啊可能我首先會用翻少少時間啦，去講翻個背景先，嚇。咁啊而家嗰個職場啦，個 job markets 啦。CFA 啦，CFA 佢自己同埋佢嗰個 exam 啦，咁啊再加翻少少 slides 啦，即係我哋如果係喺 Kaplan 啦做 CFA courses 嗰陣時咧，咁啊大概係會用啲咩 materials 咧咁樣嚇，個 approach 會大概係點樣？咁跟住我有個同事入嚟咧，就會負責咧就同大家講解多啲有關嗰個課程啦，嘅內容。好。咁啊，相信大家知道啦 ，CFA 就應該係當今咧就最 popular 嘅喺 financial market 嘅qualifications 嚟嘅 professional qualifications 啦。咁啊，無論係外資啦、中資啦，咁啊好多時你見到啦，佢哋而家嗰個recruitment 嘅 requirements 咧，都係寫咗 CFA preferable 噶啦咁樣。咁呢度就係、是、即係 CFA 佢入面咧，無論你係 candidates 又好 members 又好啦，都會遍佈曬唔同嘅工種啊，嚇 ，buy side、sell side、corporations、others、buy side、sell side 啊，咁啊 ，buy side 就包括 portfolio managers 啦、analysts 啦、traders 啦、mid office、back office 啦，嚇，咁當然唔單止係 buy side 嚇。buy side by the way 就即係嗰啲無論係你自己嘅 money 就好，或者你 clients 嘅 money 就好啦，咁啊 buy side 嗰邊係負責咧去做個 management 嘅，generally speaking， 咁啊喺 sell side 嗰邊咧，咁啊你見到好多都係 iBank 啊、analysts 啊、economists 啊、strategists 啊、traders 啊，咁佢哋 sell side 嗰邊咧，佢哋一般嚟講就唔係負責 management 個 portfolio 嘅。佢係負責 facility 嘅嚇，即係幫 buy side 點樣去做嗰個 management 嘅嚇，咁啊，所以佢哋都係有好多咧都係investment related 嘅嚇工種都包括喺入邊啦。咁啊，除此之外有其他啲 corp 啦、others 啦嚇 ，accountants 亦都係嘅嚇，咁啊都幾多 accountants 嚇 join 啲 CFA courses 嘅嚇。咁啊，好多時 accountant 入邊都好多啲唔同嘅工種嘅，除咗 audit 之外，嚇 advisories 啊、corfy 啊都有噶嘛，嚇。咁啊，偏好各行各業噶啦，而家啊，咁啊呢啲亦都係少少 examples 嚟嘅啫，嚇。如果你去睇啲 job ad， 你會見到啊，類似呢啲。咁啊，無論係即係一啲 investment related 嘅 jobs 啦，嚇，或者其他你見到其他啲 ads 都係嘅。一啲係 back office 啊，甚至係喺右下角呢個啦嚇 ，for internal control， even auditors 啊，都會係有需要，有呢方面嗰個 qualifications 會少少優勝啦。好啦，咁啊，大家去 register for CFA exam 啦嚇，咁咧就會變咗一個叫 CFA candidate 啦，係嘛？咁啊 ，CFA candidates 咧，咁呢度咧就想俾大家少少一啲 concept 啦，有邊類人 嘅會係報 CFA 考試嘅咧咁樣。咁呢個咧就根據上年做嘅呢個2019年 CFA 嘅 survey 啦。咁你見到咧喺上半橛嗰度咧，上半橛嗰度咧，咁啊當然啦，大部分咧就喺呢度嚇，有七成嘅係 full time employee 嘅。咁另外咧，有23% 係 students 嚟嘅，嚇。咁5% 咧係 unemployed 但係揾緊嘢做。咁呢啲咧就係、是、即係之前報 CFA 考試嘅。咁你見到七成嗰度咧，咁大部分咧會係呢度呢個 category 啦。是做 research analyst 的或者一些是 corporate 的 financial analyst 的。Okay. 好像就这样说除了这些真的在 front office 做 investments 工作的。另外呢这一大部分呢可能会是其他行业啊 mid office 啊 back office 都有的。Okay. 其实这个 survey 我觉得就很准的。啊、因为我之前看过其他的全部都很 US centric 的。咁如果大家知道 CFA 咧係喺美國開始噶嘛，嚇、啊、咁如果你睇翻佢之前做啲 survey 啊，大概咧佢哋會寫到咧有一半人士咧從事投資，啊你唔係做 portfolio manager 就做 analyst 嘅佢哋之前嘅 survey， 咁啊唯獨是佢嚟到上年咧出呢個 survey， 我覺得非常之準啦，因為呢個咧係 global 嘅，啊 global， 咁而家個勢就咁樣噶啦。而家喺美國以外咧，特別係 Asia Pacific，Asia Pacific 咧最大有兩個 centre candidates 嘅，一係咧就係香港啦，即係包埋大陸啦，啊 China and Hong Kong， 一係咧就 India， 呢兩度咧就對最多人考 CFA 呢個試嘅。咁考呢個試啲人咧就好 diverse 嘅個 background，OK，、okay? 咁就係變咗喺呢個正正呢個 survey 咧就係表現到出嚟。咁同埋咧亦都係咯，我都想睇提呢度啦。睇先。你報考 CFA 咧，咁啊其中一個 prerequisite 咧，可能咧就係你已經係有第一個 degree 啦。OK， 咁我相信咧呢23% 咧，啊，咁大部分咧其實佢唔單止有第一個 degree 嘅，佢而家讀緊第二個 degree 嘅，嚇。咁但係咧同時間咧，佢亦都 prepare take 埋個 CFA exam。啊，咁好多時咯，我見到即係，我個朋友啊，或者朋友嘅朋友啊，都係咁嘅女，都係咁嘅 cases 嘅。好啦，咁啊，咁究竟咩系 CFA 咧？咁样，咁啊，当然今日最主要讲就系 CFA 嘅 program 啦，个考试啦。咁但系除此之外咧，如果你睇个 CFA 嘅 institute 啦，或者佢下低啲好多唔同嘅 societies 啦，嗱 ，run 呢个 program 咧系好紧要，呢个系其中一个 pillar 啦。咁但系其他啲咧？你見到而家好多時咧，如果你上網啊，或者見到你好多媒體咧，你都見到啲 CFA 有關 CFA 嘅介紹，或者 CFA 啲 ad 嘅，啊，唔知道大家有冇留意啊？咁啊，而家 CFA 咧，其實佢除咗 run 啲 exam 之外咧，其實佢做咗好多工作咧。嗱，一來就 promote 翻啊 CFA members 咧我哋嘅 value， 啊，二來咧就代表咗咧成個 investment management 嘅 industry 咧發聲嘅。咁、啊、你見到政府有好多啲 policies 啊，咁啊 CFA institute 或者 societies 都有表達意見嘅，嚇、啊，咁變咗 CFA institute in a way 咧就變咗係一個行業嘅代表，啊行業嘅代表，咁啊呢個 program 咧如果 pass 咗之後咧，即係話喺呢個行業入邊咧就達到某一個 standard 咁解，咁啊呢度特別都係啊話係 gold standard 啦、啊、嚇，咁即係代表係喺 investment management 入邊咧嚇，overall 咧，佢而家係一個最歷史最長啦，member 最多啦，嚇，嘅一個 qualifications。咁 member 就唔單止呢個數啦，應該係多咗呢個數舊數。而家應該最新應該係17万几、18万都有噶啦，嚇，年年都有啲人考，嚇。咁啊，特別係現在講過啦，喺 Asia Pacific 呢度。OK， 咁啊 ，entry requirements 啦，一系就已經攞咗 degree 嘅，一系咧就快有 degree 噶啦，嚇、 一係咧你有四年或者以上嘅professional 嘅工作經驗啦。咁啊，點樣去攞個 charter 咧？咁就當然要考試啦。咁啊，過曬三關 ，pass the three level exams 啦。兩年有關嘅工作經驗啦。有關嘅工作經驗通常都係 finance 啊、banking 啊，或者叫做 related 啦、related 啫。即係總之你個工作個內容咧係可以同呢、這個。投資管理有關係的，找兩個 sponsors 做你 referee 就可以代表申請做 member 了樣。三個 level， 當然不是那 那麼容易一版就講給你聽啦，三個 level 是考什麼樣。只不過這裡就想 highlight 一兩個 points， 這三個 levels 有什麼 特質咁如果係大家而家準備去 level 1嘅咁 level 1呢好多都係 basic knowledge 啦 ,on valuation tools, concepts 啦。concept 係包括有好多 finance related 嘅 concept 啦。咁呢度呢有啲同學呢咁可能有啲優勢嘅。因為如果睇返 level 1個 curriculum 呢有啲地方呢會考返呢你喺 first degree 讀過嘅。即係譬如 economics 啦、accounting 啦、啲 financial analysis 啦、statistics 啦、咁呢啲咧好大程度上咧會同喺U 入邊讀嗰啲咧係有 overlap。咁當然咧，另外有啲咧係應該 U 嗰度會比較少講少少嘅即係譬如話啲fixed income 啊、portfolio management 咁樣。咁呢個就係 level 1啦咁究竟大家係之前有冇咁嘅 background 呢咁可能都會影響到你究竟要投入幾多少時間去準備呢個考試。好啦跟住 level 2呢 ,level 2呢佢就話 ability to apply asset valuation concepts to analyze 公司同埋 industries。咁睇一啲投資啦股票又好債券又好唔同證券啦或者唔同嘅投資工具啦佢哋究竟係值唔值得買value 佢嘅 value 喺邊度 ok 咁就 based on 我哋喺 level 1學咗嘅加上喺 level 2對個別唔同嘅 asset classes 啦再 apply 返落去咁用唔同嘅 models 啦唔同嘅 approaches 啦嚟計返 for example 嗰棟大廈值幾錢嗰隻股票值幾錢或者嗰隻債券值幾錢即係咁樣可以計返個 valuation 出嚟咁樣呢個亦都係喺 level 2嘅 focus 嚟啦咁再 move on to level 3呢咁 integrate 啦我諗呢個都係個 keyword 都喺呢度 integrate 咁好多時呢佢個 focus 就放咗係點樣去 manage 成個 portfolio 啦再唔係即係正正係睇個別嘅證券啊，或者一個基金啊咁樣啦。咁啊，成個 portfolio 啦，咁啊，成個 portfolio 咧，亦都係因應實際上咧唔同類型嘅 clients 嘅要求啦。OK， 咁變咗咧，同 level 1 level 2比較咧，即係如果你問我咧，我話 level 3咧會係更加 practical 啲啦。咁啊變咗 level 2如果你係計一啲價嘅 value 出嚟。佢棟大廈應該值幾多億咁樣計出嚟跟住去到 level 3呢你除咗睇嗰棟大廈值幾多錢之外呢你仲要睇下啦就住你個 clients 啦就住你個 portfolio 嘅情況呢應唔應該買個價你知㗎啦但係唔係個個都要買㗎嘛嗰樣嘢可能啱你就唔啱我啱我就唔啱你㗎嘛咁變咗 level 3就去到呢度啦比較 practical 少少啦，你又 combine 咗唔同 assets 嘅 valuations 啦，再 apply 翻落去成個 portfolio 啦，同埋咧你要睇埋呢個 client 嘅 requirements 啦，咁各樣嘢加加埋埋咧就係 level 3出現。 OK， 啊，咁啊，其實成個 flow 咧，由 one to two to three 咧，其實我覺得咧係好 make sense 嘅。咁變咗咧，如果你係 go through 曬 level one to three 咧，咁你應該係都幾 well prepare， 即係去投入去呢個 investment management 嘅行業嘅。好啦，咁啊，正話講咗 level one to three 啦，佢個 focus 啦、特點啦，咁呢度就係個 detail breakdown of 佢個別嘅topics 啊。咁即係講啦，如果你係有啲 background on 呢啲 topics 嘅，咁啊多多少少有優勢嘅，有優勢嘅啊。咁跟住去到 level two 咧，就會 shift 咗落去其他 areas 啦。OK。咁啊，照過往咧，CFA Institute 做嗰啲調查出嚟咧個 feedback， 即係考生考完之後啦，咁問翻，喂，你覺得個考試邊一度最難啊？嚇，邊個 topic 最難啊？嚇，你覺得你邊一方面最冇信心會 pass 咁樣？你估咧喂？啊，咁呢度有十個唔同 topics 啦，ethics 啦 ，quantitative econ。Financial reporting and analysis 就 very much related to accounting 啦 ，corporate finance 啦，同埋唔同類型嘅投資啦。好啦，你覺得啊過往嘅考生邊一科你覺得最難咧？你估 ？Ethics 啊 ，ethics。咁啊，根據嗰個調查報告咧，就 ethics 咧喺 level one 同埋 level three 咧，佢哋都話難。我唔知點解 level two 佢冇人話，可能 level two 有其他啲更加棘住嘅嚇。咁、的確又啱嘅 ethics 咧，佢哋可能特別喺 level one 啦，冇擺足夠嘅時間去 prepare 嚇、因為個 preparation 咧喺 level one 咧，的確係比較 time demanding 嘅。咁如果你係個 focus shift 咗落去其他 topics 咧 ，ethics 咧你都要自己留意一下嘅，真係好啦。咁除咗 ethics 之外咧。其實仲有嘅，FRA 呢個 financial reporting and analysis 都話難嘅嚇。咁我覺得咧，佢難就難在邊度咧？多嘢。如果大家之前係冇接觸過嚇啲 financial statements 嘅嚇，由零開始咧，咁啊真係要放翻多啲時間落去嘅嚇，因為個 coverage 好闊嘅。好複雜啊！咁呢個係佢嗰個個範圍啦，係一個挑戰嚟嘅。個範圍係一個挑戰嚟嘅。咁啊，除此之外咧，fixed income 啦，都係啊 ，fixed income。咁啊 ，fixed income 咧，佢就嗱範圍都闊嘅嚇。咁但係我覺得佢難咧，唔係單單係範圍個問題，係只不過咧又係少接觸。咁好多時呢喺亞太區嘅或者喺香港啦、即係好多我哋啲會接觸到嘅投資呢都係股票嚟嘅咁變咗呢對債券呢咁債券好多時呢啲個印象之中呢成日話即係回報啦個腰係幾多啦咁樣就係、咁多嘅啫咁但係點樣去分析佢呢咁好多人都有講股票分析嘅就對乜乜公司呀、點樣了解呀、咁啊，覺得係而家抵買唔抵買咁啊？咁啊，好少人講話債券而家抵買唔抵買嘅，淨係話個腰夠唔夠高嘅啫。咁變咗咧，就比較少啲去認識呢類型咁嘅投資。咁啊，故所以我就覺得咧，喺 level one 咧難啊難在咧，有啲係個範圍好闊，有啲咧就係我哋根本係唔 familiar 嘅，好少講到嘅，咁啊，每個人都有少少困難的啦去 tackle 個 level one。OK， 咁啊個 format 嗰度咧就上晝啦、下晝啦，分開兩個 sessions 啦，都係用 multiple choice 嘅形式啦咁啊三個鐘頭上晝，三個鐘頭下晝，120條問題每一個 sessions 咁啊120條問題就俾三個鐘頭，即係180分鐘啦。咁每條問題咧就平均就1.5分鐘。OK， 咁呢度又係啦，又講翻啦 ，time management 啦、，time management 咁自己去計翻條時間啦，唔好擺太多時間落去某一兩條問題嗰度。咁之後咧，出年咧有少少改制啦，因為 一向以嚟咧 ，Level One 咧一年兩次機會嘅。咁啊，咁當然啦，大家我諗都係會報翻今年噶啦，嚇12月嗰個試噶啦。咁但係即係 for information 啫呢度，出年咧個 Level One 咧會有4次機會嘅，啊，2月、5月、8月同埋11月都可以考。OK。咁但係 Level 2同埋 Level 3不變啊，嚇都係一年一次啫，嚇都係6月啫，嚇只不過 Level 1咧係多啲機會。OK， 咁啊，如果你今年12月 pass 咗嚇，咁就可以喺出年即係2021年6月咧去報考 Level 2啦。咁如果係要等到出年2月先考 Level 1嘅，就算你 pass 咗咧。都唔夠時間去報考6月嘅 Level 2噶啦。OK， 咁當然啦，個 time schedule 係你哋自己決定啦，嚇點樣先覺得自己最合適啦，嚇。好啦，咁啊過往嘅 passing rate 啦，你見到 Level 1、2 and 3啦。如果講 Level 1咧，大概都係40%鬆啲啦，40%鬆啲。啊，咁同埋你見到咧，其實佢又真係幾穩定嘅，係嘛？40%鬆啲嚇，過往嗰5年都係差唔多咁上下，咁啊離不開都有啲 line curve 嘅成分嘅咯，嚇 line curve 嘅成分啦，咁啊好多時都係啲同學都會同我哋傾下，咁樣要考幾分先合格啊咁樣，咁我哋通常咧就係呢啲都係 official guideline 嚟噶啦，嚇如果份卷你做到有70分咧，你都合格噶啦，肯定嚇應該咁講啦，可以話。一除非、啊、可能你 ethics 都到到零分嘅咁樣，好難講啦、啊、如果你 4-4 拉雲嘅咁樣，你總共加埋有70分咧，都應該會冇問題啦。咁但係我攞唔到70分，會唔會就代表我 pass 唔到咧？又唔係，唔係嚇，咁、啊、視乎你啲對手啦，你啲對手。我就一開始就講過啦，而家有啲乜嘢類型嘅人士會報考啊？咁啊，有70%做緊嘢嘅，咁啊，其他有20%讀緊書嘅，咁可能搏曬老命啫，由朝讀到晚嘅去考嘅都有嚇。咁、啊、如果佢哋考得好嘅，咁你即係變咗 relatively 啦，相對啦嚇、啊，就會有些少壓力噶啦。OK 嚇、啊，咁啊，正話講過，其中一個難處咧喺 Level 1咧，就係佢啲 volume 啦好大啦，咁啊，俾大家少少一啲ideas 多成點啦。咁啊，據過往嗰11年啦，2008至2019年啦，平均嚟講咧，佢有530個 LOS 嚇 ，learning outcome 嚇、啊，即係讀完個 curriculum 咧，應該學咗530樣嘢。咁呢530樣嘢咧，就係、是、coming out from 3196頁嘅 readings。咁你諗下，大概正話有10個唔同 topics 啊，係嘛？10個唔同 topics， 咁啊，咁每個 topics 咧可能有1-2個 sessions， 每個 sessions 咧就可能有大概有3個唔同 readings 啦，嚇，3個唔同 readings。咁每個 readings 咧，咁啊幾廿版嚇，咁啊跟住咧就可能要你學識咗10至15個 learning outcomes。咁變咗 in total 咧就係呢啲數啦。in total 就係呢數，好啦，咁變咗咧，我哋會覺得咧，就係如果真係要去，有信心、有準備去考呢個試咧，你點樣去 prepare 個 approach 都好緊要嘅，嚇、啊，咁而家就都仲有好多時間嘅，6月，咁你12月先考，嚇、啊，咁啊大概有半年時間啦，嚇、啊，咁你自己或者我哋大家可以諗下嗰、那個 planning。是怎樣？咁喺 Kaplan 咧，我哋嘅 planning 咧就係、是，頭先 education 應該大概係2.5個月左右嘅嚇、啊。education 我哋有個 education 嘅 program 啫嚇，咁、啊、大概先60，大概50幾60個鐘頭啦嚇。咁、啊、我哋會喺有陣時即係視乎你係報邊班啦，有陣時會喺夜晚上堂啦，有陣時會喺 weekend 上堂啦咁樣。咁啊，一個禮拜就大概6個鐘咁啦，咁大概總共係大概10個禮拜咁樣。 咁我哋就會 cover 曬咧嚇喺成個 curriculum 入邊嚇。咁我哋就唔會梗係會逐頁逐頁咁講啦嚇。咁一間會睇啲 slides 我哋個 approach 係點樣做。咁喺呢個 education 嘅 program 入邊咧，就係 core learning， 有一個印象先，所有嘢嚇佢個500多个 learning outcomes 咧嚇都應該識曬噶啦。但個問題就係你記唔記得曬啫？嚇呢個好大 challenge 噶嚇。根據過往經驗就係嚇識曬，但係過咗兩個月之後翻嚟咧，跟住同我講翻，喂阿 Sir， 你講過咩呢啲都有噶，都有，即係正常啦。你500多样嘢必須記得曬啊嚇。咁變咗咧就要個 revisions 啦 ，revisions 咧再講多一次咧嚇。咁可能咧再過兩三個月你又唔記得嘅。嚇，咁嗰陣時咧就會講少少，跟住就做多啲 Q&A 嚇，咁啊 reinforce 翻嗰個 learning 嘅效果啦。咁啊再最後咧就嚟翻個 mock exams 啦，咁啊等大家熟習咗個 mock 個 format 啦嚇，有個經驗啦，咁到時就唔會即係啲未諗過嘅嘢突然間發生咧，咁啊 surprise surprise 就唔係幾好啦。OK， 係啦，咁啊我哋就會用一啲 slides 嘅形式啦嚇。就將佢所有嗰啲 readings 咧、啲 concepts 啦、major points 咧，就放落啲 slides 嗰度。咁啊，我哋就會 go for slides 嘅喺上堂嗰陣時。咁啊，正話講過啦嚇，你 concept 嘅嘢你要做你先識嘅。咁啊，所以就 phase two 就係 revisions 啦，同埋最尾咧就有個6个钟头嘅 exam mock exams 嚇。OK， 咁 so far 有冇問題啊？好，如果冇問題咧，睇睇 slides 啊，我哋上堂。咁基本上就喺 slides 咧，就係 correspond 翻佢啲 learning outcome statement 嘅。因為就係講過啦，如果啲 readings 3192页咧，咁啲 readings 咧，人哋寫嗰陣時咧，就唔係話寫俾你 CFAI institute 去做 examination material 噶嘛。咁只不過 institute 覺得哦呢份 reading 好嘅，咁啊用嚟咧俾大家做 material 準備去考試。咁變咗咧，個 reading 入面咧，你要知道咧邊一個 parts 咧，先至係 related to 個 LOS learning outcome statements 啊。咁變咗咧，啲 slides 咧就 based on 呢樣嘢咧抽翻嗰啲 readings 咧 relevant 嗰啲咧放翻曬出嚟咁解嘅啫。OK， 咁我哋係冇加新嘢落嘅嚇。咁呢度咧有幾張 slides 咧，就係有關 econ 嗰個topics 啦嚇。咁啊 ，econ 嘅 topics 咧，你見到咧有陣時好多啲 LOS 咧，譬如話呢度咁樣啦。咁啊，有關啲政府嘅貨幣政策啊，個財政政策啊 ，monetary 同埋 fiscal policy 啦。咁佢 LOS 要你 describe 啊。咁啊 describe， 咁啊除咗 describe 咧，見到有關 econ 咧，好多時候叫你 describe 啦。describe 就即係話乜嘢？你要知道呢樣嘢係咩嚟啦。What is it？ 同埋咧，佢有啲咩特質？佢嘅 characteristics。OK， 咁佢就會針對啲 characteristics 咧，出翻啲題目問翻大家嘅。啊，問翻大家。咁但係除咗 describe 咧，一陣間會見到咧，咁啊有啲可能會再深入少少嘅。嚇，可能要大家要 compare 啊、contrast 啊、explain 嘅一啲嘢。嚇，咁嗰啲咧嗰個 understanding 嗰個要求就會再高啲嘅。咁呢度變咗。如果佢要大家知道要 describe 個 objectives 啦，中央銀行啦 ，central banks 啦咁樣，咁唔係全世界所有央行咧嚇個 objective 都一樣嘅，咁我要分啦。有啲邊啲係大家都會做嘅，咁呢度個 price stability 啦，因為呢個好緊要嘅，即係你央行咧，其實基本上咧就係即係 provide 一個好穩定嘅一個環境啦，俾人哋營商噶嘛。咁其中咧嗰個價格穩定咧係最緊要。咁但係除此之外咧，你見到咧仲有其他嘢嘅。咁視乎唔同國家啦、唔同 regions 啦咁樣。咁有啲咧就會睇個 job market 啦，不過都少啲嘅啦。咁比較多啲咧就睇翻個 economic growth 啦、exchange rates 啦。咁有啲咧會 target 個 interest rate long-term stabilities。唔一定嘅喎，唔一定嘅喎。咁但係近期咧，近呢幾年咧。咁你估邊個 objective 咧？即係 central bank 比較 focus 多啲嘅， 啊啊、Full employment 係嘛 ？Full employment 都有睇到嘅，都有睇到嘅嚇，都有睇到嘅嚇，都有睇到嚇。咁 啊, 啊, 啊 ，full employment 啊，或者嗰個 economies 啊，都係會有個比較大啲嘅啊 influence 啊 ，on 嗰個央行嘅 policies 啊。inflation 咧好多時咧，而家就變咗個 central bank 嘅 target 嚇、啊、，central bank 嘅 target。咁好多時都話，而家嘅 inflation rate target 係 2% 啫嘛嚇，而家 2%。咁啊，好多時都唔到嘅嚇、啊。過往嚟講，好多時都話 inflation 咧有個 misconception 咧，就話啊 inflation 唔好，但係而家慘就慘在咧，我哋冇 inflation 嚇、啊，冇 inflation。咁我哋而家好多時咧，個 central bank 個 focus 咧就按咗個 inflation 嗰度。咁但係咧，呢、這個咧就好得意一個 dilemma 嚟，唔可以太高，唔可以太低，唔可以太高，唔可以太低嚇。咁一間會講講噶啦。咁啊好多時咧，個 inflation rate 唔係話零係最好嘅嚇、啊，零好穩陣啦，係嘛？零嚇冇 inflation 嘅，全部都 in real terms 嘅，咁啊好容易咯。咁但係咧，好多央行咧就驚嘅，你如果係零嘅話咧。突然間個經濟弱少少咧，就變咗 deflation 啦。一 deflation 咧，佢就冇一啲工具咧可以去 tackle 嘅 deflation。咁呢啲咧就變咗係，如果佢嗰個 exam 要求再深少少咧，你要慢慢一步一步咁再諗落去。咁但係咧喺呢度為止咧，你唔需要諗咁多，因為佢就係要求你 describe 啫嘛，知道啲 characteristics。即係譬如話佢個 target 係 inflation 啊，或者 target 係個 growth 啊。或者佢有啲乜嘢央行佢個 target 會係 exchange rate 嘅 stabilities 咧？咁咪好似香港咁咯？咪香港就唔係 central bank 啦 ，Hong Kong MA。但 Hong Kong MA 其中一個好主要嘅 objective 咧，就是、maintain 香港嘅港幣啦，同埋美元啦個 exchange rate 咧係好穩陣嘅嘛，因為我哋 pack 咗俾佢啊嘛。嚇，咁變咗咧呢、這個咧就反而 Hong Kong MA 咧會睇得好緊嘅。啊，咁變咗唔同類型嘅 central bank 咧，可能有唔同嘅 focus 啦。咁啊，跟住落咧啊 ，inflation 咁啊，要大家咧 contrast 下啦。我明白到乜嘢 inflation 以外咧，仲要諗諗啦。有啲叫 expected 嘅，有啲 unexpected 嘅。咁啊 ，expected 嘅 inflation 同 unexpected 嘅 inflation 對嗰個經濟嘅 impact 有咩唔同咧？咁啊 ，expected 預咗噶嘛？你預咗嘅，如果你做生意，你預咗嘅，你計 pricing 咧，你預咗條數落去噶嘛？如果 unexpected 咧，就即係你唔知噶嘛 ？unexpected 嚇、啊，可能咧 turn out to be 多咗或者少過你之前嘅諗嘅。咁啊 ，unexpected 咧，我哋就要留意一下咧，佢對個經濟會帶嚟啲乜嘢 additional cost 啊 ？additional cost 嚇、啊，對經濟。咁喺呢度咧就講咗少少啦。Lenders and borrowers 嘅 relationship 啦，如果有啲 unexpected inflations 嘅話，同埋咧就係喺production functions 咧，即係 investment 嘅 decisions 嗰度咧，如果有啲 unexpected 嘅 inflation 出現嗰陣時，咁通常咧都唔好噶啦。唔好嘅意思即係話咧，喺個 lending borrowing 嘅 relationship 嗰度咧會 end up。with 一個高啲嘅借貸成本，喺個 production decisions 嗰度咧，亦會令到人哋咧會比較 hesitate 去投資嘅。啊，咁呢啲咧又係你將個 expected 同 expected inflation 咧 contrast 出嚟咧，佢可能會做好多唔同類型嘅問題啦。嚇，咁啊 A、B、C， 咁問你邊個 most likely 係個 additional cost of 個 unexpected inflation， 咁你就 A、B、C 度揀出嚟咯。好啦，咁又系啦，去睇翻个 policy 嘅 tools 啦。咁啊呢啲咧，咁啊呢度做咗有三样嘢吓，三样嘢呢个个 policy rate 啦 ，OMO 啦，即系公开市场操作啦，啊，咁同埋嗰个 RRR 啦吓 ，required reserve ratios 啦，三个 policy tools 啊，咁啊可以系扩张性 expansionary， 可以系 contractionary。咁就呢三樣嘢咧，咁大家就知道啦。 啊，在啲咩時候央行會用哪一個 tools 去做啲乜嘢？啊，去做啲乜嘢？啊，咁啊，同埋咧，中間可能有啲 term 要認識一下啦。啊，譬如話啊，美國嗰邊 policy rate， 因為冇喺呢度，啊有，啊，咁都分開兩邊講。啊，一邊咧叫做 discount rate。discount rate 咧就係個央行啦，嚇，就同埋嗰啲primary dealers 啊，嚇，即係某一集 banks 嘅借貸計個 rate。咁另外一個咧，咁啊報紙啊或者媒體成日 quote 嗰個咧叫 fed fund rate。咁啊 fed fund rate 咧就係個 interbank 嘅 rate 嚟嘅，嚇。咁呢兩個係唔同噶。咁所以咧就唔同個 tools 咧，咁可能入邊有少少唔同嗰啲 terms 啊。咁大家要知道佢啲咩分別啦。好啦，咁啊 ，for example， 咁啊，正話啲唔同嘅 policies 可以擴張或者收縮啦。咁樣如果當我哋要做一個擴張性嘅 expansionary 嘅 monetary policy 啦，嚇，咁會 affect 到啲咩咧？個 result 係咩咧？咁樣嚇，咁啊，一二三四呢四樣嘢講咗出嚟啦。嚇，咁呢四樣嘢。簡單啲咁樣 highlight 翻出嚟咧，就係會影響到 interest rate 啦，會影響到 asset prices 啦、growth 啦同埋 currency 啊。咁啊，好 typical 嘅一個問題咧，就係某類型嘅 policy， 即係譬如呢個 case expansionary 啦，佢個 impact on 呢四樣嘢會係高咗定低咗？多咗定少咗嚇？咁呢啲 relationship 咧，咁大家就要熟啦。呢啲嘢就好啦。咁啊，跟住咁啊，就講曬啲 central bank objectives 啦，佢有啲咩 monetary tools 啦。咁啊，呢啲就仲要認識一下啲 qualitative 嘢，佢做啲咁嘅 policy。佢自己要點樣啊？有啲乜嘢又係 characteristics 啦，啊，佢個 policy 咧先至有效，先至有效，啊，咁有陣時冇效嘅，有陣時冇效嘅，因為如果佢想擴張性嘅減息，但係人哋唔信佢嘅，繼續可以減息，咁反而調翻轉咧，唔肯使錢，唔肯投資，啊，咁變咗佢個 policy 咧 expansionary 咧對個 growth 咧都冇 impact， 咁啊點樣先至有效咧？咁樣呢度就講咗三個 characteristics 啦。其實我覺得呢三個都係 interrelated 嘅，咁啊知道 independent 啦，佢自己獨立啦，嚇，咁啊獨立咧要分開兩個角度嚟睇啦，咁又係啦，每一個 characteristic 有少少 terms 嘅，你要明白咩叫 operational independent， 咩叫 target independent， 嚇 ，operational target， 咁啊 target 即係你要做啲咩啦，咁啊 operational 就係你點樣做啦，嚇，咁有陣時就係可能。可能政府或者可能個 president 話俾你聽，佢嘅 target 係乜，跟住咧叫你自己搞掂佢，咁你就冇咗個 target 嘅 independence， 但係你有一個 operational 嘅 independence 啦。咁啊，唔同地方就有唔同嘅情況啦。但係呢個都唔緊要，因為考試咧唔好將現實世界嘅情況咧嚇投放落佢條問題嗰度。OK， 我哋就係條問題講啲乜嘢咧，就是、based on 條問題俾我哋嘅 information 去答就得噶啦，嚇。好啦 ，independent 啦 ，credible 啦，啊，即係你講得出要做得到啦 ，transparent 啦，你點樣去 measure 你自己咧？啊，點樣 measure？ 譬如話你要推高通脹嘅，咁你講得清楚咩通脹嚇？你個通脹係點計出嚟啊？你而家做到咩情況啊？你係因應啲乜嘢嘅 economic 嘅 parameters 咧嚟制定呢個 policy 咁樣啊？咁變咗你見到又係聯儲局嗰邊咧嚇。啊呢幾年咧就越做越透明嘅，嚇呢頭開完會嗰頭俾個 minute 你睇咁滯噶啦，嚇咁跟住咧好多啲 sell side 嗰啲咧就將上次嘅 minute 同今次嘅 minute 咧對比一下啊嘛，啊究竟你邊度轉咗咧咁樣，嚇非常之透明嘅而家做到，咁就係想知道咧，個 FOMC 咧嚇希望佢個 policy 咧全世界都認同嘅，嚇如果全世界認同咧咪一齊，啊佢想 expand 嘅你咪同佢一齊做咯，嚇。咁啊 ，don't fight 嚇個central bank。咁啊，呢個亦都係 另一個 rundown 啦，如果你係做 expansionary 嘅 policies 啦，學買債啦，嚇 buy securities 啦，咁啊 as an example 咧，就話翻俾大家聽，當聯儲局買債，市場上高有啲乜嘢嘅 changes 嚇 ？OK， 好啦，咁啊 ，based on個 central bank 嘅 objectives 啦，個市場嘅情況啦，同埋啲 tools 啦，有好多種方法嚇，去達至佢想做嗰樣嘢嘅。咁啊，可以歸納成咧呢三個 targets 嚇。咁呢啲亦都係 related to 個 central bank objective。咁就係講咧 ，inflation 而家好多時咧。個 central bank 咧就係 put more focus onto inflation 啫嘛，咁變咗佢定立咗個 inflation target， 跟住用曬佢所有唔同類型嘅工具咧去達至呢個 target 啦，嚇，咁呢個係 central bank 嘅其中一個做法。咁但係咧，如果講翻十年、廿年前咧，又未必一樣嘅，啊，咁可能咧十年、廿年前咧，佢哋係個 interest rate targeting 嘅啫，因為咧個 inflation 咧就反而冇咁重要，唔係冇咁重要，都重要，但係除咗 inflation， 仲有其他啲 objective 㗎嘛。譬如個 growth 啦咁樣，咁你又諗下個 growth 同個 inflation 點樣平衡呢，就用個 interest rate targeting 去平衡佢咯。咁最後尾 exchange rate targeting， 咁當然啦，又 go back to objective 啦。exchange rate 如果你係 pack 咗去其他 currency 嘅，咁你梗係用其他 currency 對你個 domestic currency exchange rate 嚟做個 target 啦。你要通過唔同嘅工具去 make sure 咧個 exchange rate 咧。如果你係 fix 咗嘅，嚇個 pack 就唔好喐。如果你係唔係 fix， 但係可以喺一個好窄個 band 嗰度 fluctuate 嘅，咁啊視乎佢而家喺個 band 嘅邊個範圍，跟住你就 adjust 翻呢個 tools 嚇，令到佢唔會走出個範圍。好啦，咁呢啲啊全部都係有關 central banks 啦，喺我哋 level one 個 curriculum 咧包咗嘅 LOS 嚟嘅。咁啊，最後呢張。咁如果好似正話咁講啦，我哋interest rate targeting 啦 ，for example 啦，可以 target on 一個叫 neutral 嘅 interest rate， 即係將嗰個利息咧嘅教導喺一個水平嗰度咧，唔會太刺激但係又唔會阻礙經濟增長嘅，咁啊好 neutral 啦，係咪？咁一般嚟講咧，呢個係視乎你個 real GDP growth 啦，同埋 inflation rate 啦。咁其實呢條咁嘅好簡單 equations 亦都可以做到啲問題出嚟問大家㗎喎。咁佢會點樣做呢？咁留意啲 terms 囉。佢會有啲 ABC 唔同嘅 choices 呢咁出嚟。咁可能呢唔係 real GDP， 可能 nominal GDP 加 target inflations 啦。可能係 real GDP 加 expected inflations 啦。咁就變咗係盡量會 confuse 你哋。所以要記清楚。記清楚嚇，條 equation 好 straightforward， 但係咧就 make sure 你明白佢係邊一樣嘢講緊。好啦，咁呢個係 interest rate target 咯，咁佢 target 咗，咁佢照而家嘅情況，你想收縮，抑或你想擴張嚟決定你個 rate， 咁呢個就係你個 monetary tool 咯。OK， 嗱，唔會去到好深入喺 level one。咁但係正話講嘅所有啲唔同嘅issues about the central banks 咧，都喺個考試範圍裏面。所以咧，你要知道佢嘅 characteristics 同埋佢嘅 implications。implication 就包括佢哋互相嘅 relationship。O 唔 OK？ 有冇問題？有問題一陣間仲可以問，不過而家我就 pass 俾我同事講下啲 course 嗰啲 detail 先啦。